Welcome all of you. So today our class will be on the topic section of solids. Okay, so section of solids means we will be cutting a solid using a section plane, and we remove one portion of the solid and then we draw the projections of the remaining portion of the solid. Okay, so in this figure you can see this is the projection of a triangular pyramid. The triangular pyramid is resting on HP on its base with one base edge perpendicular to VP. So we have drawn the symbol position and then we have done the front view from the top view of the base polygon. Okay, so now in section of solids we will be cutting the solid by using a section plane. Then we remove one portion of the solid from that and then we will be drawing our projection. Okay, so in section of solids we will be dealing with these four types of sectional planes. You can see the first type of sectional plane is a horizontal section plane. That means the section plane will be parallel to the horizontal plane. That is called as a horizontal section plane. Second type of section plane is a vertical section plane. That means the section plane will be, if you consider this as our horizontal plane and this as our vertical plane, a section plane which is perpendicular to the horizontal plane, that is known as a vertical sectional plane. Now the third type of sectional plane is auxiliary inclined section plane. That means the section plane will be inclined to HP. That is one possible case. Second case is a section plane that is inclined to VP. And the fourth type of section plane is a section plane that is parallel to profile plane, or a section plane that is perpendicular to both HP and VP. In that case, we will have to take the side view of the solid to get the actual idea of section. Okay. Now we can represent these four types of section plane in this given sample figure. So consider the first condition, that is horizontal section plane. Horizontal section plane means a section plane that is parallel to HP and perpendicular to VP. Okay. So parallel to HP, so that section plane can be drawn in front view. This is the condition, a section plane that is parallel to HP. So we are using this section plane to cut the solid and then we remove either the top portion or the bottom portion depending upon the requirement. So this is condition number one. Now this is second one, that is a vertical section plane. Vertical section plane means a section plane that is perpendicular to HP and perpendicular to HP and parallel to VP. In that case, the section plane will be viewed in top view only. So here if we draw a section plane like this, that means in this case the section plane is parallel to VP and it is perpendicular to HP. So in the top view it can be seen as a straight line. So this is case number two, a section plane that is vertical, which means perpendicular to HP and parallel to VP. Now the two auxiliary inclined planes, that is first one, section plane inclined to HP, again a section plane that is inclined to HP. You can see this is a section plane which is represented as a straight line. This is inclined to HP and it is cutting the solid. So this is condition number three. And condition number two of sub of this condition number three, that is a section plane inclined to VP. So a section plane like this, which is inclined to VP. This is the third condition. And last condition is a section plane that is parallel to profile plane, or which is perpendicular to HP and VP, perpendicular to both HP and VP. So that section plane can be actually represented in side view only, that we will be discussing as a different case. Okay, so when coming to making projections of this section, we should be having some basic concept. That is, one thing is how to represent a section plane. So a section plane is actually represented as a continuous line, but it will be having thick ends and in between it will be having a thin line. So continuous line with thick end is the line which is used for representing a section plane. Now the section plane will be named according to the traces that it is going to make.
You can see that in case of a horizontal section plane, it will be having a vertical trace. So we will be naming this section plane as VT, and we will be using capital letters for that. And in case of a vertical section plane, you can see that the vertical section plane will be having a horizontal trace, and we will be naming the section plane using HT, capital H, capital T. Then we will be representing the viewing direction of this section plane by using arrow marks also. For example, in this case, if we want to view the shape of the solid that is obtained after section, we have to view from top view, and hence we will be using arrow marks which are pointed downwards. So this is how we are naming a section plane. Thank you.